Hallelujah. Thank you, wonderful Lord. We give you praise. Such a beautiful presence of God here. Such a beautiful presence of the Lord here in this place right now. I want everybody where you are right now to know that Jesus Christ loves you. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. He put His love on the line for you. He came from heaven to earth. The Almighty God, born of a woman, became a man to be able to die our death on the cross, to carry our sin, so that we could have peace with God. You don't have to carry that sin, that guilt, that condemnation anymore. When you accept Christ, you accept and receive forgiveness, life, heaven, God's love, God's calling you, God's drawing you. Don't wait. That's the gospel. That's the good news. That's the power of God unto salvation for anybody who will believe. If you don't believe it, it doesn't work for you. But if you will believe the gospel, the good news, that Jesus Christ paid for your sin to redeem you, to make you pure and right before God, if you believe that, that power will save you. So right there where you are online and also here in God's presence in this house, every eye closed, if you want to be included in this prayer, open your heart right now. I'm going to ask everybody to pray, but I want you where you are right now to open your heart and receive Jesus Christ into your life as your Lord and Savior. Pray with me right now. Everybody in this house, Lord Jesus, I believe You are the Son of God. I believe You died for me and that You rose again. I believe the gospel. I believe the good news. You took away my sin. Tonight I confess You are the Son of God. And I receive You now as my Lord, as my Savior. Wash me in Your blood. And I thank You, Lord Jesus, for redeeming my life with Your blood. Amen. Those of you that prayed that prayer, I release the peace of God over you. All your sins and disappointments and mistakes and all the things of the past, they're all gone now. Everything's new. In Jesus' name, the blood of Jesus cleanses you. God gives you a new heart and a new spirit. And you'll never be the same again. Let's all give the Lord a praise for everybody who comes to God. Amen. Hallelujah. You may be seated in God's beautiful presence. It's so important for us to give people opportunity to come to God, to make right with God. There are people walking around with guilt, with shame, with many things holding them back. But what better place to come to God than this place? This is the house of God. Here you come as you are and you surrender your life to Him. This is not religion. We're not playing games. We're not here to entertain people. This is the wrong place if you came to be entertained. No, 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 no. I present you with the good news, the gospel. That's the power of God for everyone who will believe. How many of you believe in the gospel, the good news, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior? Give Him a high praise offering. He's worthy of the praise. That's the power that transforms us. And I want you to know we're so glad that you are here. So glad that you are connected. We have been expecting you. Where have you been? We've been praying for you, believing that you would then come. And here you are. I want to welcome each and everyone visiting us for the first time. Do we have a first-time guest here tonight? Just raise your hand, wave at me. God bless you. Good to have you with us. God bless you. Good. Wonderful. God bless you, guys. Good to have you with us. And over there as well, God bless you. Welcome tonight. Thank you for being with us and being a part of this time. And just open your heart. As you can feel, there's such peace here right now. And that's what God's house is. It's a house of peace. some people experience that when they come here, when they just come in the building, even before the service starts, they feel that. It's because it's God's house. And so you are so welcome. The brochure that's been given to you tells you a little bit about our ministry, our vision. Open it, please, if you would. Inside of it, there's a slip in there asking for your details. If you are willing to, would you please share it with us? We'd like to stay in touch with you and let you know of our upcoming events. We've got things happening throughout the year. And we'd like to let you know about that. We'd like to support you. You're not, it's for no other purpose but to stay in touch, keep you updated with our special events. So if you would fill it in for us and then place it inside the offering when we give God's people a time to give to God of their offerings and to worship God with their giving. I want to welcome all those online as well. Please let me know in the comment section where you're watching from. We'd like to know that as well. Blessings to each and every one of you. Peace be upon you and upon your life in Jesus Christ's name. Hallelujah. Now, dear friends, I want to speak to you just a few moments from God's Word, 1 Corinthians chapter 3, and from the 4th verse, 1 Corinthians chapter 3, and the 4th verse. Paul the Apostle writes and says, "For when one says, I am of Paul, and another, I am of Apollos, are you not carnal? Who then is Paul and who is Apollos, but ministers through whom you believed, as the Lord gave to each one?" Listen to what the Apostle Paul writes and says, the word. He says, "I planted, Apollos watered, but God gave the increase. So then neither he who plants is anything, nor he who waters, but God who gives the increase. Now he who plants and he who waters are one, and each one will receive his own reward according to his own labor. For we are God's fellow workers. You are God's field. You are God's building." Can we say that together? Say, we are God's field. We are God's building. Now, dear friends, the Bible shows the natural and then the spiritual. And I want to speak to you tonight on work the process. Work the process. They're online. Put it in the chat. Work the process. Tell the person next to you, work the process. There's a process that is made known to us here. And we see that the Bible uses the natural to explain the spiritual. Jesus used the natural to explain or reveal the spiritual realm, the spiritual principles. He spoke of seed, of fish, of nets, talents, of sheep, of vineyards, of weddings, to reveal spiritual truths. So in this portion, we see that planting, watering, and increase is shown to us to reveal a spiritual truth, a spiritual principle. This is a process. And I want to say to you tonight that I believe many of you in this year, and I'm prophesying to you right now, many of you are planted, and that there's a watering going to occur this year. And the seed that has been dormant is going to be touched and moistened with that water and with the Spirit and the Word coming upon it. And that hard shell is going to break open, and there's going to be an increase. There's going to be a harvest. There's going to be a manifestation of what God has purposed for your life. If you believe that, give Him a praise offering. And I want to say to you that it is important to work the process. To be planted is destiny hidden or concealed. To have a harvest is destiny revealed. So the moment that seed comes up and there's a harvest, you'll see the manifestation of that seed. When a seed is planted, you can't see it anymore. When a seed is planted, when it is sown, it is hidden. It literally goes through a death. It dies. Remember what Jesus said, the seed cannot grow unless it dies. So I want to begin this year by telling you, don't be afraid of death to ego, death to pride, death to anger, death to those issues and attitudes. Let those things die. Oh my God, did I come to the right place? Because it's the only way the seed can actually produce something. Without that seed dying, Jesus said, it remains alone. So I stand before you here in January to tell you this year, allow the seed within you, allow that potential, that gifting, that dream, that anointing within you, allow it to go through the process. In fact, work with the process. Some people oppose it. They don't like it, especially the planting season. They don't like the planting season because when something is planted, nobody sees it. We don't even see it. We wonder what's happened to it. In fact, it's planted. It feels like it's been buried and there's been dirt that covers it. But how many of you know, even though planting and burial looks the same, there's a difference. Because when you plant something, you expect growth to come from it. It's planted for a reason, for a purpose, to develop, to grow, to expand, and at the right time, it will manifest and bring forth fruit. I believe God brought you to this house, to this ministry, to this place. He planted you here in this soil for a reason. Paul says, I planted. Come on, Apollos watered, but God gave the increase. Some of you maybe came here for the first time or a couple of weeks. Why? Because God's planting here. Some of you have been planted for a while. It feels like everybody has forgotten about you. God's forgotten about you. No, you're just being planted. Some of you feel like there's a lot of dirt on top of you right now. Don't worry, you're planted. You're not forgotten. Amen. Something is growing on the inside of you. Something is developing on the inside of you. When I look back at the process that I've been through, I can tell you now, I did not grow. The seed in me did not grow through comfortable times. The seed did not grow in me when I was on holiday, lying at the beach, drinking passion fruit and lemonade. The seed didn't grow. The seed grew when I was forgotten, when I was rejected, when I was left by myself, when I had nobody. But God closed my room and sought His face. Come on, that's when the seed grew. When nobody knew, something was growing. And so I want to encourage each and every one of you, you're planted right now. It's not over for you. It's not finished. This is not the end. This is not your final chapter. But that seed will remain dormant. It will not manifest or produce anything until some watering takes place. And I want to tell you that in this church, in this ministry, there's a process of planting and watering, and we go through the cycle. And I'm here to tell you right now, there's watering going to take place on the seed. It's happening even now as I speak. It's happening in this atmosphere. Because I've learned there's some plants that don't need much. They just need the right environment. If they're planted in the right environment, for some reason, they start growing. They start producing because they're in the right climate. They're in the right environment. And I'm here to tell you, you're in the right environment. You're in the right climate for something in you to come alive, to grow, to expand. There's more in you than what your family thinks there's in you. Let me tell you, there's more in you than your colleagues think in you. There's more in you than people can see with their eyes, because the potential, the seed, is hidden from man so that man cannot influence it, so that God alone can multiply it and work the seed. But we need watering. He says, I watered. So we see that there's this process. The farmer takes the seed from its environment, where it lives on that tree, and then he takes it and he plants it somewhere else in the soil for the purpose of growing it. It's called agriculture, to force it to grow, to make it grow. Agriculture is not, it's man, it's man-made. The process of planting, watering, and how many of you know that's man? That's agriculture. They can take seed and go plant it somewhere in the field, water it, and it will grow. Doesn't have to be on the tree for it to grow. Can you say amen? So that's agriculture. So I'm here to tell you that some of you have been taken from that environment that you were in that wasn't good for that seed. And you were taken from there, and God has released you in a field, planted you in a field where He says, this is where you can grow. This is where you can develop. This is where I can bring out of you. You need this type of watering. Hallelujah. Would you tell the person next to you, you're in the right place? Oh my God. The seed doesn't ask questions. The seed doesn't say, why are you doing this to me? Leave me alone. I don't want to be. No, the seed says, take me. Please put me in the ground. Cover me with some dirt and give me some water. I mean, the seed doesn't complain because the seed wants that process. It works with that process, and then something very powerful happens. The seed waits on something supernatural to occur, something that man cannot do. Only God can do it. He says, I planted, Apollos watered, and he who plants and waters are one. He says, but only God can give the increase. The seed knows I can be sown by man and watered by man, but only God can make me grow. And I'm here to prophesy over you that what has been planted in your life, what has been watered in your life, is going to increase, manifest, and come forth, I believe, in 2022. If you believe that this year is your year for the increase to manifest, just put up that hand and say, it's my year. I take it. I appropriate it. That business is going to manifest. That creative idea is going to manifest. Come on. This thing's going to come out of your loins, out of your spirit. There's people, there's disciples coming out of you. You're going to give birth to things. You're going to release things. You're going to raise up your family, your sons, your daughters. It has to increase. And only God can give the increase. Only God can do it. In fact, the seed is not worried about it. The seed waits. There's a seed inside of your spirit, underneath the soil of your body and your mind. There's a seed of God. There's a potential there. There's a gift of God there. Every born-again believer has supernatural potential on them, on the inside of them. The moment you were born again, you were given gifts, you were given potential, you were given giftings. It all was released into you. You're a seed bearer. You're a carrier of seed. Now I want to say, work the process. Don't resist the process. Don't resist being planted. Understand it's part of the process. Don't resist the watering. It might feel funny when that water comes on the seed. It may feel strange. It may feel like I'm drowning here, but it's not drowning you. It's causing that hard shell to soften up. There's a hard shell around so many people when they come into the house of God. I've seen them come in here. Many people have come in with their hard shell. They've told me about it. I remember a lady that came here. She had lost her son. She had lost her child. She was hurting. She was grieving. She came in here, but the watering of the Word of God caused that hard shell that she had built up around herself to become so soft that eventually it broke and she became happy again. She was whole again. She lived again. She smiled again. There's a hard shell, an outer case that many of us have around us, holding our seed of potential down, holding that thing down, suppressing what's inside of us. The watering of the Word, the watering of the Word of the Spirit of God is going to cause that shell to crack. I prophesy over somebody in the house
that the shell is going to crack this here. The shell that causes you to be an introvert, that causes you to hold back, that causes you to be insecure, that causes you always to take second place, that causes you never to step out, that causes you not to forgive, that causes you to stay behind. That shell is breaking this here. The water of the Word and the Spirit is coming upon you. You're going to transform. Somebody say, I'm transforming this year. That seed is sown as a little seed with a little shell. But how many of you know it doesn't look like that when God gives it the increase? When it comes out totally different looking. Doesn't look like that anymore. There are shells here. I want to tell you, by the end of this year, I believe it's not going to be just a little shell anymore. There's going to be a manifestation of God's purpose, destiny, and plan inside of your life. You're going to be a carrier of the precious seed of God. Can you say amen? So the watering causes this. It's very important not just to be planted. You got to be watered. You got to be watered. It's important to be watered by the Word, watered by the anointing. And as you are being watered, there comes a moment where God gives the increase, and I believe prayers are going to be answered. There's been prayers that you've been praying for me, the church, that God says, I'm going to answer prayers. Before the return of Jesus Christ, there's going to be an outpouring of answered prayers on the earth. The incense bowls are full before the throne. Can you say amen? There are prayers that Jesus prayed in John 17. There are prayers that the apostles prayed, that the church has prayed for 2,000 years, that God says in the last days, I'm going to answer those prayers. I'm going to release a harvest in the earth like the world has not seen. How many of you believe your prayers are going to be answered? There's going to be a harvest. You know, prayer is like that. I take a prayer, a request, and I plant it. I pray about it, and I'll come back tomorrow and water that. I'll come the next day, and I'll water that. I'll come a few days later, and I'll water that request. I water it with my thanksgiving and with my praise and with my faith, and I keep on with it. I don't let that seed that I've sown through prayer, I don't let that wait. There are prayer seeds that are dormant in the lives of people that have not manifested yet because they're not watering it. Water that seed, that request, with your tears, your faith, your praise, your confession. Plant a seed concerning your future, your job, your child, whatever the request is, plant the seed through prayer in the presence of God. And then every day come to that request and water it with your praise. Father, I praise you for that. Father, I thank you for that. Father, I believe I receive that. And confess it. You're watering the seed. Eventually, God gives you the increase. It's like I said this morning, prayer has to be consistent to build up momentum. And momentum eventually releases breakthrough. A sudden divine intervention of God. Water the seed. The watering causes the seed to manifest. And once the watering has occurred and the increase has manifested, you can never, I need about 10 amens on this, you can never be normal again. Once the seed has broken through the shell and manifested, you can't get it back in the shell. I dare you to try do it. Put that thing back into the shell. You can't do it. It came out of the shell. It's transformed. It will never be normal again. Come on. Never go back to what it used to be. I prophesy to you, you'll never be normal again. You've come too far. God's brought you too far. You've been watered too much. You've cried too many tears. You've paid the price. You've come too far. I need about 20 people to give God a praise if you agree that you'll never be normal again. Woo! Who wants to be normal anyway? Oh my God. Normal is dull, boring. I don't want to be normal. I don't want anything normal. I want everything to be out of the box, out of the shell, out of the limitation. Come on, I need some out of the box praise for God right now. Come on, give him some out of the box praise. For your breakthrough, for your blessing, for your favor, for your business, for your increase. Woo! Hallelujah. Tell three people around you, you're coming out of the shell. You're coming out of your shell. Wow. You're coming out of your shell. Woo. Hallelujah. Do you believe that? Some of you have cried many tears to get to this moment. Oh, I don't know who I'm prophesying to. Maybe it's somebody online. You've watered the seed with your tears. Let me tell you something. The Bible says in Psalms 126 and verse 5 that tears are part of seed time. 125 and verse 6. Those who sow, or verse 5, 126 verse 5. Those who sow in tears shall reap in joy. So crying tears are a part of sowing. But nobody reaps a harvest and cries about it. Because when you reap, you rejoice. When you reap, you're happy. Because you're actually holding the sheaves, the manifestations. So I want to declare it over you that you are stepping into your harvest. You're stepping into a time of rejoicing. You've cried enough. I say you've cried enough. You've wept enough. It's time for your tears to turn into joy. I release joy. I release rejoicing. I release it. Right now, God will wipe away the tears. You've cried over your children. You've cried over your health. You've cried over your finances. You've cried over the condition and the state that you've ever been in. But no more. No more. I say no more. You're stepping into your harvest. Hallelujah. You shall reap in joy. You shall reap in joy. Your children will serve God with you. Your wife will come back into your arms. Come on, whatever you need from God, lift those hands. Take it, take it. It's your portion now. He who continuously goes forth weeping, bearing seed for sowing, shall doubtless come again with rejoicing, bringing his sheaves with him. Doubtless, shall doubtless, no doubt, no doubt. No doubt. In this church, no doubt. There's no doubt here. Doubtless, no fear here. Doubtless, we shall come. Bearing our promises. Bearing our promises. Bearing our promises. Bearing our dreams and our visions. Bearing it. Carrying it. Oh, can somebody pray in the Holy Ghost with me? I believe we're going to see no more tears in our church. We're going to enter into rejoicing in 22. How many of you are entering into rejoicing mode? We're going to rejoice from now on. Oh my God. We're not going to cry over the losses of 2020 and 21. I say we're not going to cry and weep over the losses. We're going to rejoice in 22. Our God is giving us a harvest on the seed, on the tears, on the sacrifices, on the commitment. Woo. Dear friends, would you stand for a moment in order to see the increase? We have to come to that place of no more doubts. Doubtless. Doubtless. This year of 22, we're going to come back rejoicing. We're going to come back celebrating the doors that God opened for us. I sense now, prophetically, doors are opening for some of you. There are some international connections opening up. There's some places, high places, God's opening up. There's some stuff you've dreamt about, but you never saw it because it was a seed. It was hidden, but now it will come into manifestation. You'll walk in it. You'll embrace it. You'll carry it. It will be upon you.
Yeah, come on, laugh a little bit. Rejoice a little bit if you can. Dance a little bit. Jump a little bit. Do something. Hallelujah. Whatever you can to rejoice. So God, I'm happy, God. I'm happy. I'm happy. I've planted that seed. I watered it. But now you give the increase. Pastor Mark, we need to rejoice. We need to rejoice. The stuff we've planted and watered, it's manifestation time. Oh, it's manifestation time. Woo! Go ahead, go ahead, go ahead, go ahead, go ahead. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, go ahead and praise Him. Praise Him. Rejoice for a few moments. Woo! Manifested God. We praise You right now. As an act of faith, that we are in our harvest season, in Jesus' name. Just 30 more seconds. Yes, come on. Woo. Hallelujah.
As you remain standing, I want to drive the word home. It says, we are God's fellow workers. You are God's field. You are God's building. Did you hear what it said? It said, we are God's fellow workers. We're partners. We are working with God. Listen carefully to me. Do not work against the process. Work with the process. Work with God. Work with the leadership. I say work with the leadership, work with the vision, work with what we're doing this year, work with the process, get on the trainings, get into the seminars, get into the meetings, get active, get into the prayer gatherings, do whatever you need to do to work with the process, because you're a fellow worker. Work with God, work with the Word, work with us. You are God's field. You are God's field. In other words, work with God. Work with the process. Work. Don't just spectate. Participate. Would you please say, I'm a participator. They're online. Put it in the chat. Say, I'm a participator. Oh, yes. The field. We are God's field. The field is the grace. The area that God has graced and gifted you to work in. In God's field, there's a place for you. Each and every one in the kingdom of God has a place in God's field where they can be effective. So I call upon God's workers here tonight. I call upon God's people here tonight. Let's work the field. Let's work with God. Let's work with the process. Let's water the seed. I want to take it further this year. I want you to plant, water, and expect God to give you a harvest. Amen. Plant the seed of the gospel in somebody's life. And even if they don't respond to you, don't worry about it. God's going to send somebody else to water the seed. And you and He are one. Oh my God, come on somebody. You can't maybe get everybody saved, but you can plant seed. Somebody will water. Another will water, and then one day God will give the increase and they'll be saved. Can you say amen? Somebody shout amen. I release that upon you. I want to activate you. I feel that. Would you lift those hands? There's an activation in this house. Father, in the name of Your Son, Jesus, the Messiah, whom You raised from the dead, the head of the church, in his mighty name, I stand in my office. I take my place. I step into my office now, and I activate every person from the front row to the back row. I activate them with the word. I activate them in the supernatural. I activate them in the calling and gifting of God. I activate them now in the process of God, in planting and watering, in harvest. Now, let there be an activation. They will never be normal again. They will never be normal again. They are activated. They will never be dormant again. They are activated. They are carriers of the power of God, the presence of God, the fire of God, of revival, of the anointing. Shake each and every one of us, Lord, and revive us. Put your fire upon us. Lift those heads up high. And from your heart, I want you to cry out to God. Ask Him now to put the fire on you. Ask God right now to put the anointing on you. Ask God right now to release this grace upon you. Oh, come on, water that seed inside of you with your praise, with your prayers. Be activated now in the supernatural. Be activated in the anointing. Be activated in the gifts. Be activated now in the Spirit of God. How many of you believe that you've been activated with God's word? I launch you, I ignite you in the name of Jesus Christ with His word, with His fire. Work with the process. Let the word change you this year. Let the Spirit transform you. Let God burn in your heart. Let Him come and bring out the character in you that He has called you to be. That He called you to be. Just pads. He called you to be. There's more to you. You're not yet what He destined you to be in your fullness. There's a process. We're not going to stroll into 22, sit back and spectate and become what God called us to be. We have to work with the process. We have to be equipped. We have to be taught. We have to be pushed. We have to be aligned. We have to receive correction. We have to be mobilized. There's greatness in you. That's the only reason I'm preaching to you passionately, like you're the only one listening to me. Those dormant seeds in you are going to become alive. You're going to dream again. You're going to see things again. You're going to expect and hope things again. The hopelessness breaks off of you now in Jesus' mighty name. For a moment, just close your eyes and receive the presence. The Holy Spirit is ministering to you. That's it. Break it. Break it, Lord. Break open the heart. Shall on those hearts. Thank you, Lord. Oh, shikarabakatarabasiyata. Shebroshtikarabakata. There are some of you that feel God's presence now. You feel God's anointing upon you now. You feel the power of God on you, the presence of God on you. In Jesus Christ's name, I release that anointing upon your life right now. Let this word be confirmed in your life. And dear friends, right now, I want to pray for people that say, Apostle, I've got a mountain in my way. I've got an obstacle. I've got sickness in my family. I've got sorrow. I've got financial issues, and you need a breakthrough. You need a miracle. Even those online, I'm going to pray for you too. But everybody in this house tonight that says, I need God's power to break through in my life on my behalf, and I have faith for it.
If that's you, you need to slip out of your seat, come down to the altar, and I'm going to pray for you and with you now for your breakthrough, for your miracle, for your answer, for your release, for that circumstance to change. God's going to do it. It's not the work of a man. It's the work of the Holy Spirit. He does it. Many of you have come to the place of realization where you've now know man can't do anything. It's only God. Only God can do it for you in your circumstance, in your life, in that court case, in that issue. Only God can do it for you. We're going to pray. We're going to pray right now. We're going to pray right now in Jesus' mighty name. Here where you are standing in this altar right now, would you lift your hands to Him and close your eyes? I want you to get your eyes on Jesus. He's the author and the finisher of your faith right there where you are. In fact, just one glimpse will change everything right now where you are standing. Lord, I present the people to you as they stand in this altar. And Lord, right now I ask that you would envelop them in your presence, your touch. Let the anointing flow through them. Church, would you stretch your hands with me towards the people? Let's agree for them and with them now. And also those online, we keep you in prayer as well. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus the Christ, right now, we lift up every need at this altar right now before the Lord. Father, you know each one. And I pray, we pray in the name of Jesus Christ that you would supply that need. Father, we pray that you will open the way. We pray that you will cause them to have favor. We pray that you will surround them with favor, that no weapon formed against them shall prosper. Right now, in Jesus Christ's name, I remove from your life every negative word spoken over you, every curse spoken over you, every judgment spoken over you. I remove the curse from your life. I remove the abuse, the hurt, the pain, every form of bondage, that thing that holds you back, that you run back to the whole time. Oh my God, I release you from that in Jesus Christ's name. Be loosed in your spirit, soul, and body right now. And the Lord is healing your heart. The Lord is restoring your heart. And the Lord is going to give you power to forgive right now. Forgive right now. The Lord gives you power to do it. And I command your body to be healed. I want to ask and hear the whole church, all the leadership, pray for them in the spirit. Come on, release the power of God. Release the power of God over them. I'm just seeing things in the spirit here. God's restoring a relationship here between a daughter and a mother. God is also delivering somebody here from addiction to alcohol. God is also healing physical bodies here. In the name of Jesus Christ, I command that weakness and that fatigue to go from you, lift off of you, for you to be strong, your bones to be healed, your marrow to be healed. In Jesus Christ's name. Shikaraba kotaraba sikaraba kotaraba shikaraba kotaraba kata yeto kotaya. Thyroid be healed. Throat conditions be healed. Now, skin conditions be healed. Growths be healed. In Jesus Christ's name, I command every form of abuse to go, to be broken in the name of Jesus Christ. Every soul tie, I sense right now there's somebody here. There's a soul tie keeping you in that relationship, but I break it over you right now. Loosed to be free, to be free and loosed to be what God called you to be in Jesus Christ's name. There online, I release the power of God. I release the anointing of God in Jesus Christ's mighty name right now. Right there where you're standing in this altar. Let the Lord touch you and breathe upon you. He comes, He does it right now. Oh yes, you are my hiding place, Lord. You always fill our hearts. Whenever I'm afraid, I will trust in you. I will trust in you.
give you a new heart. Open your heart. Let your tears flow. Walk to the sea. Open your heart.
That we can trust in you, that we can say tonight boldly, I'm strong. I'm strong in the Lord. I will not fear what man will do to me. The Lord is my helper. He has promised he'll never leave me nor forsake me. There where you are, would you say, I'm strong? Say it, I'm strong. One more time, I'm strong. In the strength of God. You're strong enough to overcome. You're strong enough to defeat that giant. You're strong enough to defeat that addiction. You're strong enough to get that marriage back together. You're strong enough to get off of that sick bed.
Yes.
One thing I've discovered is you can't stay on that bed. You got to force yourself. You got to push yourself. You got to, even if you have to lie on your face and pray, but you pray. And the strength of God will come back upon you. And when He makes you strong, how many of you know there's no power that can hold you down because it's the supernatural strength of God? All the young people here tonight, all the students going back to school, to university, I declare right now over you, the strength of God is upon you. You will not be afraid of what you're going to study this year, what you're going to face this year. You're going to go back to that school. You're going to go back to that place of learning with the strength of God, the boldness of God, with a sharpened edge. I loose the anointing upon you. No fear upon you. The seed in you is going to manifest. Hallelujah. Amen. God's dream and vision for your life will come to pass. In Jesus' name. Well, I believe the Lord has sealed this message in our hearts. Those of you in front, you can go back to your seat. God bless you. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We give you praise. Team, you could just stay here with me for a moment as I give people an opportunity. You may be seated, church, just for a moment. They're online. What a powerful time in the presence of God. I don't know about you, but I feel refreshed. I feel revived. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The presence of God revives you. It refreshes you. It renews your strength. I believe the Lord has done that for us tonight. What a precious word. We receive that. Lord, thank you for it. Give you praise. And how many of you know that when we receive God's word, we should sow into that word? We should. That's what the scriptures teaches us in Galatians, the 6th chapter and the 6th verse. It says, let him who is taught the word share in all good things with him who teaches. Do not be deceived. God is not mocked. For whatever a man sows, that he will also reap. He who sows to his flesh will of the flesh reap corruption, but he who sows to the Spirit will of the Spirit reap everlasting life. How many of you know the flesh profits nothing? That's what Jesus said. He said, the flesh profits nothing. But if you sow into the Spirit, you reap a mighty harvest. The time you spent here tonight was one of the best investments you've made. He who sows to the Spirit will of the Spirit reap everlasting life. Verse 9, let us not grow weary while doing good, for in due season we shall reap if we do not lose heart. Therefore, as we have opportunity, let us do good to all, especially to those who are of the household of faith. Especially to those who are of the household of faith. How many of you know this is the household of faith? I say we are the household of faith. And the scripture teaches us, if you want to do something for somebody, do it for God's people. Especially those of the household of faith, because God will always reward you. He'll always bless you. Dear friends, tonight I want to give an opportunity to give, to contribute into this ministry that teaches you, that's here for you, that prays for you, that ministers to you. If you're blessed by this ministry, then bless it and support it, because as you do that, you partake of the grace. There's a partnership, there's a blessing, there's a grace that is exchanged. And God will bless you. He'll reward you. He'll provide for you. I believe you will never have to worry about your financial problems if you put the kingdom first. If you win souls, if you build God's kingdom, God's house, God will never let you go under if you support His kingdom and His work. He'll always make a way for you. He'll keep you. He'll provide for you. In fact, some of you sitting here tonight, you're a living, walking testimony through 2020 and 21 that God sustained you, kept you, provided for you. Would you lift that hand and thank Him for it? Wow, what has the Lord done? The Lord has done mighty things for us. So I want to give an opportunity to honor God. In fact, let's do it now. If you need a tithing envelope, please slip up your hand and usher will get a tithing envelope to you. If you want to use your card, you can do so at the back at the welcome desk. There are people there that will assist you online. Join us now in this moment. All our details are there. You can do an EFT or use the Zapper. And those of you in the building, you can come right now to the altar whenever you're ready and sow a seed. Plant that seed and water it as you walk back to your seat with thanksgiving and praise. Hallelujah. And as they come, let's sing gently this song. I will trust in you, Lord. We worship you, Jesus. With songs. Right now, the seed that was sown, the seed that was planted right now, we water that seed by singing to you. We trust in you. Father, multiply the seed, increase the seed, supply every need. Give your people favor, bless them. They shall be the head only, not the tail, above only, not beneath. Blessed. Going in and out in Jesus Christ's name. And everybody agree and say amen. Amen. Hallelujah. I want to ask Pastor Mark, thank you, team. God bless you. I want to ask Pastor Mark to come and just share with us a few announcements, and then we'll dismiss the service. Were you blessed tonight? Are you strengthened tonight? Are you refreshed? Hallelujah. Thank you, Pastor Mark.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Just as the apostle was preaching about the process, we at RWC also have a process. It's called our journey to success. It's walk in his footsteps, it's encounter, it's discipleship training. We also have marriage seminars and great things that are happening in the year, and we would love you all to be part of what God is doing. And we also have a powerful youth group that gathers every Friday night at 7 p.m. I encourage you to send your young people. They've got great things in store as well, great events that are going to be taking place this year. Send your young people. Like I said this morning, invest in your teenager's destiny. Send them to this house so that the seed that you planted can be watered, amen, and that God can bring the increase in their lives as well. And then as well, I encourage you to get involved in our life groups. We have life groups running through the different areas during the week on a Wednesday night, or some is on a Thursday night. You can go and be part of that life group, impact your community, and raise up disciples around you. If you don't know of a life group in your area or a leader in your area, just contact the office, and then we will lead you and guide you to that life group leader. Or I encourage you to download our RWC app. All the information is on that app, and we can communicate that way as well. And then every Thursday night is a time of prayer at 7 p.m. I encourage you. You don't have to feel like, you know, you have to have a strong calling to come to pray. Every one of us is called to pray. Every one of us is called to intercede and to stand in that gap for somebody. And we have corporate prayer here on a Thursday night at 7 p.m. It's for everybody. You don't have to register. Just come and pray with us. Not only are you standing in the gap, but as well, your prayer life is being developed. You are growing in your prayer life, and I can guarantee you'll walk out of this place you're blessed. That's every Thursday night at 7 p.m. And then I want to encourage each and every one of you to begin to start to prepare yourself for our 3 days of prayer and fasting. This is going to be a powerful one for something, Apostle. I don't know why, but I feel something special this year with this prayer and this fasting. Every year we do it, but there's just something different about this year. And I believe that God is about to release something special in our lives. So don't miss out. Set that aside. Already mentally prepare yourself. Physically prepare yourself, and spiritually prepare yourself. We're letting you know with enough time in advance to prepare yourself and to go on that prayer and that fasting with us. That is going to be on the 30th, the 31st, and the 1st of February. It starts the Sunday, the 30th. That evening, we're going to be starting with special meetings called Ignite the Fire. Then the Monday night at 7 p.m. and the Tuesday night at 7 p.m., we're going to come together again, and we're going to come into this place with expectation. How many of you are going to come hungry for the fire of God to be set ablaze in the hearts of every one of you? Not only us, but to go with us when we go into our workplaces. Amen. Esther prayed, like Apostle said last week. She prayed, the whole of Israel prayed together, and they were delivered and were set free through prayer and fasting. I believe that God is going to set the church free this year to go into the highways and byways and set the city ablaze. Can you say amen? Once again, that's the 30th to the 1st of February at 7 p.m. And then this is a call to each and every one of you that have been visiting us for some time. They're online as well. Maybe you are in our city and you have not yet become a member of this church. You've been visiting for some time. How many of you know you can visit, but then you can leave? When you become a member, you begin to participate in what is happening in the house. So I want to encourage each and every one of you to make the decision this year to come under this covering, to say, you know what, this is my house. This is my spiritual father. Pastor Maria is going to be my spiritual mother. I open myself up to receive the teaching of the Word of God through this house. If that is you, I encourage you to register on your way out for our Walk in His Footsteps seminar, which is going to be starting the 7th of February until the 8th of February. It's a Monday and a Tuesday night at 7 p.m. for about an hour and a half. And that those two nights, we teach you how to walk in the footsteps of Jesus. But as well, we tell you more about this ministry, and it's set up so that we can get to know you better and see how you can slot in and help us to expand the kingdom of God. Once again, don't wait for that. register on your way out. And then we're also very, very excited because these are one of the truths that we have to do is we have to be baptized. The Bible says each and every one of you be water baptized. And if you have not yet been water baptized, you've accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. It's time to go through the waters. And on the 13th of February in our evening service, we're going to have a special time to baptize people, bury the old and resurrect them into the new. So if that is you, please register for that so we can prepare all the certificates that is needed for that night. God bless
Amen.
You.
Amen. Thank you, Pastor Mark. So powerful. People of God, you are very precious to us. We love each and every one of you, praying for you at all times, daily, that God would cover you, bless you, and prosper you. Would you stand as I bless you before you go? There's power in a blessing. A blessing is not a prayer. When you bless somebody, when somebody in a spiritual position blesses you, it's not a prayer, it's a command. A blessing is commanded. So would you, there where you are, receive it. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I speak over your life, over your destiny, your future, everything pertaining to your life, everything connected to your life. Right now, I speak the blessing, the full blessing of the new covenant. The full blessings that there are in Christ, the blessing of Abraham, the dew of heaven be upon you, upon your family, upon everything you put your hands to in this coming week and months that lie ahead in Jesus' name. And the church agrees and says, Amen. So be it for your life. We love you. We appreciate you. Won't you just tell somebody as you go you appreciate them? We look forward to seeing you Thursday night for prayer. God bless you.